surgical technology in ceremony. These ladies have worked very hard. So if you don't mind, if you could all stand and welcome the class of 2024.
Super proud of them. I got to talk to them a little bit in the hallway. I got to walk into their classrooms every once in a while and watch them do surgery and all the cool things that they do there. It's cool. I got to talk to them also a little bit about some of the great surgeries that they partook in while they were going through their class. I am 100% confident that this group of students is ready to go out there and challenge the world and be awesome. You know, but one thing, we've done a couple other pinning ceremonies for some of the other health professions programs that we had on campus. And the one challenge, and I know you guys are gonna be at graduation tonight, right? So we'll be able to shake your hands at graduation, parents, relatives, friends, and family, please come to that as well too. But the one thing I wanna say to you all is this, right? You went to one of the best community colleges. Last night I think I said the universe, right? Isn't that what I said, the universe? So you've gone to one of the best community colleges, I think, in the universe, of course. I'm sort of partial to some of my students here. But we are the best in the state. We were the best in the state the last 2 years. And we've got amazing faculty that do a wonderful job meeting our students where they're at, getting them to where they need to be. We have amazing staff that does the same thing, reaches out to students and get them there. So we know that you're ready to go out there and be rock stars. So now it's your time to do that. One of the things that shows the best about Walter State or makes us look the greatest is our graduates, right? So I don't want you to go out there and just be surge techs, right? I want you to go out there and be surge techs, right? I want you to be next level. I want to hear that one of you guys created a new machine that makes surgery easier. Or I want you to go out there and win like the Nobel Peace Prize. Or I want you to go out there and be awesome and talk about Walter State and all the good things they have, because I know you guys have the ability to do it. So it's going to be awesome. Congratulations. Look forward to this wonderful ceremony and look forward to seeing you tonight. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Mixon. I will say something about his surgical skills. I'm glad he's the president. We'll leave it at that. And since he mentioned our previous graduates, all of our previous graduates that are in the audience today that graduated the program, please stand up. Just stand up. Don't look at me, Chris. Yes. Bailey is Dr. Sheila Williams. She is currently interviewing. Thank you, guys. Appreciate you being here. And I don't need this for that. I also want to introduce somebody that, if I did not have this person with me daily, these guys would be sitting where they're at. This is a tough program to run by yourself, and I have the most awesome faculty instructor in the universe, I'm a student group. The most awesome faculty instructor in the universe, and I could not do what I do without her, so Ms. Victoria Henley. All right, so, surgical technology is a profession you know about. In fact, when these students started, I would dare guess that there's at least one of them that had no idea what they signed on for when they did. It's always you, Michelle, always. So for those of you that don't know, what these ladies do now, or are going to do daily, is they're going to stand up in an operating room, shoulder to shoulder with a surgeon. They are going to pass instruments, and that's not their only job compared to popular belief. They are also not nurses, sorry to the nursing faculty, but they're not nurses. They stand up during surgical procedures, shoulder to shoulder, hand to hand with a surgeon. They are the voice of that patient laying on that table that is asleep. They are the patient advocate. Those of you that have had surgery in the past, you never knew they were there, did you? Nobody knows who we are. They are the unsung heroes of the operating room. Their sole purpose and job is to protect that patient from infection, from injury, from an angry surgeon, and from anesthesia. My apologies to any anesthesia providers in here before I say this. And from anesthesia who's playing on Amazon, on their phone, during the case. Because that's what they do. Anyway, these guys protect the patient. They ensure safety. And it has been my pleasure to spend the last 2 years with these ladies teaching them those skills. And that's one thing that I think they will tell you. They don't leave our lab if they can't do the job. I will send you home before I'm going to send you to be dangerous to the patient. These ladies are ready. They're the best of the best. And so at this time, the class of 2024, thank you guys very much. All right. How many people that actually work in healthcare are here today? Please stand. Because it takes more than just the surgical tech. So let's give a hand to all these healthcare professionals. Center. And Sabrina is probably working. Brooke Clevenger. She nominated Kimberly Christian, also from LeConte. Yep, they're busy today. And Ms. Anna Price nominated Amanda Adams, also from LeConte. Moving on, Jessica Garland nominated Amanda Zippy Moore, and I would be in trouble if I didn't say Zippy. Amanda, are you here?
I lied, she's not here. Sorry.
Good job. Amanda is from Morristown Hamlin Medical Center. We have Danielle Nichols, who nominated Erica Hall, also from Morristown Hamlin Medical Center.
Go ahead.
Come on.
You're the first one.
I know she's here. Thank you. Abigail Timlin nominated Sharon Bell from Morristown Hamlin Medical Center. I know she's here too.
Doing something right, y'all.
Rochelle Suggs nominated Morgan Zist from Tenova Newport Medical Center. Morgan is also one of our previous graduates.
I nominated you for this honor since you provided such an enriching experience for me during a stressful but mind-blowing opportunity. You are an exceptional preceptor who provided the ideal balance of instruction, supervision, and support. I feel empowered to push myself beyond my comfort zone and to work on having patience. Working with you was so valuable and rewarding. I learned to understand that no matter what the person in front of me is going through, regardless of their health or history, they deserve the best we can give them with the tools we have. I've seen you navigate through difficult and complicated situations while keeping your cool and patience. You're a terrific patient advocate, and I'm very impressed by all of your efforts. I sincerely appreciate your patience with me and taking the time to teach me properly. You guided me through each surgery step by step. You took the time to explain what I did wrong and what I needed to work on. Because of you, I know I'll be a good surgical tech someday. I hope that when I become a preceptor, I will have the necessary knowledge and experience to help train the next future generation of surgical techs. As surgical techs, we are extremely important. We are extremely important since we must maintain a sterile and organized environment while working in assisting the surgeon. We are the patient's voices. Working as a CST may be both difficult and rewarding. Because of you, I am completely confident in my ability to be a good surgical tech and care for my patients. You have taught me so much over the past few months. I moved from having you help me step by step to you taking a seat and watching me set up and perform the surgeries on my own. Thank you so very much. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the person I nominated, Brian Baker.
Graduating high school, I was at Walter State looking for something in the healthcare field. I was looking for a challenge, and trust me, I found it. I never known such a profession as this existed until recruited by none other than Ms. Stephanie Austin. Once in the program, I cannot believe that someone so crucial for the care of the patient could go unrecognized. In hours of studying, I found that it would take perseverance and a good deal of dedication to continue in this program. I found purpose and a home in surgical technology. Ms. Tori Finley, Ms. Stephanie Austin, and Ms. Holly Lawson are the best teachers and mentors one could ask for. The women sitting behind me and beside me today did not only show me my potential as a tech, but as a person. My hope is the relationships that we made continue for years to come, and the lessons learned we will take with us into our careers. Congratulations, class of 2024, as we step into this next season.
My name is Tori Finley. I'm the instructor for these wonderful graduates. And at this time, we're going to call each one by name and have them come forth and do their pinning ceremony. So at first, and you have to give hugs. Okay, hug to heart, hug to me. Everybody understand? Okay. Good. Okay, at first is Ms. Abigail Aguilar.
Stephanie, you need to face this way.
Yeah.
Thank you. I'm going to just get a picture of your mom.
Lana Broyles.
This is hard on us, too.
Yeah, it is. Ms. Brooke Clevenger.
Hey, you guys are more than welcome to yell. We don't care.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Oh, my time.
Aaliyah Fleenor. Jessica Garland. Haley Holt. Danielle Nichols. Anna Price.
She can sing too, by the way. She told me I couldn't say that, but I didn't.
Rochelle Stubbs. Takesha Talley. Abigail Templin.
Thank you.
Poker, Lana.
Poker.
Why she didn't watch you?
At all. Keep telling me that I'm going to miss them more than any other class. Anybody want to argue?
Me.
Kristen's the favorite, always.
So here's your class of 2024. So at this time, we're going to have the graduates state the pledge of the Circle Technologist underneath each of your chairs. You can stand and read it.
Did you all practice like I said?
Uh-huh.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
I don't believe you.
Thank you, Brooke. So again, my name is Tori Finley. I'm in charge of final remarks. I just wanted to comment on this cohort. This is actually my 18th graduating cohort that I've been in charge of, or been able to have the honor to teach. And of that, yes, they are one of my favorites. They know that, I tell them that every Monday. this is an exceptional group of ladies. They have worked very hard. When they tell you this program is not easy, they are not lying. They have to get through me, they have to get to Stephanie, they have to get through clinicals, they have to do all of these things, and they have to do it our way. And each one of them rose to the challenge, so you should be exceptionally proud of these graduates. Exceptionally proud. Now, we know that they can't do this by themselves, so I would like the graduates to take a moment to applaud their family and friends for all the support that they have received over the last 2 years. We'd also like to thank all the clinical sites and preceptors that are out there helping our students. We know that's not an easy job either. So the list goes on and on. We'd like to thank our faculty that have supported them in their general education courses as well, administration that has helped them achieve their goals as well. So thank you so much for coming. I'm going to have them stand so you guys can take pictures. But again, one round of applause, last round of applause for the graduating class of 2024, and we will see you this evening.